Welcome back. My name is Chris, and in this video, we're going to be taking a look at how to enable features in NetSuite, as well as some of the other key setup locations that exist in the system. So with that in mind, let's dive into it. All right, so here we are in the system, and the first thing I should point out is looking up here in the top right, I'm currently in the administrator role. That is very important because most of what I'm going to show you here is only accessible if you are in an administrator role. If you're in some other accounts receivable, et cetera role, you probably will not have access to any of this. So keep that in mind. But because we are in the administrator role, we do have a tab here that says setup. And this tab contains a lot of the key configuration related features that exist in NetSuite. Most important of them are if we come to company and down to enable features. This contains, and I'll even click into this, basically a checklist of available functionality in the system, at least that has been provisioned to this particular account that can be turned on. This is the main frame of the system in terms of what do we want to have enabled. And while I'm not going to walk you through each of the various enable features that are here, you can see it goes on for many different tabs, that is more relevant depending on what you're trying to set up specifically. Are you a manufacturing company, maybe just a services-based, et cetera? Really, I'm trying to give you a context of how to approach these things, as well as some tips for them. When it comes to enable features, the main thing you should keep in mind is this is not a place to just start messing around with features. You don't want to just start turning things on or off. You could create some severe problems for the system. Any feature that exists here, before turning it on, you should first off, not only read the short description they have here, you can also click on the field help, which gives generally some more info. And then I would recommend you go to Suite Answers and anything you're gonna be interacting with, you look at the full documentation on it on Suite Answers to understand not only what it does, some limitations, and also how to best configure it. Because many of these enable features are tied together in ways that you wouldn't necessarily anticipate. So for example, certain features you can't turn on unless several other features have already been enabled. Other features have to be really started in tandem with something else, so two features that go together. And then some features, this is the biggest risk, once you turn them on, you cannot turn them off, especially if there have been transactions that have interacted with that feature. So for example, multi-book accounting is an example where you turn it on and then you're stuck with that. So there are certain features you don't want to just check to see if you want to interact with it, you may be stuck with it permanently after that. So I definitely recommend you do your research before just going in and interacting with any of these things. And of course, overall, when you're dealing with enabled features, you have so many different things that are available here. Anything from enabling projects in your system, if you have serialized inventory, or maybe specific tax solutions, all of that functionality will, or at least should be contained here in enabled features. But there are other areas that are very important for the system. For example, there's many different preferences pages where you can find key features. So if I come back up to setup, and under company, we have a few examples such as general preferences up here. We have email preferences. Arguably the most important preferences page is here under accounting, and down you can see we have accounting preferences. And there are a lot of different preferences here, everything from invoicing to finance charge preferences, etc. But let's click on accounting preferences for now, because again, this is arguably the second most important behind enable features. There are tons and tons of different preferences enabled here. And arguably some of these things are just full-fledged features that you really could, you wouldn't be surprised if you found them under enable features. So this is another great place to come if you're looking for functionality to configure or turn on in the system. But this starts to beg the question of, well, you've got all of these different places where there's settings and features that you can interact with. How do you locate them? How do you know exactly where to go to? And this is something I notice a lot of administrators and even consultants struggle with. And there's a few tips in terms of how to locate exactly what you're looking for. So first off, if you don't know what the feature or the preference is called, you just have a concept of what you're trying to do, there's a couple things you can do. First off is if we come over here, we always have support and go to Suite Answers. Suite Answers has so much documentation in it. It's a great place to start and check to see if you can find what is the relevant thing to handle what you're looking for. Another thing I would recommend, and it's increasingly becoming helpful, are different AI chats. So whether you use Claude or Gemini, ChatGPT, Grok, it really doesn't matter. You can go into these AI chat channels and basically give in plain English what you're trying to accomplish, and it will give you some instructions. Now, they tend to hallucinate. So I would say about 50% of the time, it gives you things that just don't exist in the system or it leads you down a wrong path. However, this is the perfect kind of thing where if the system, if the AI chat is hallucinating, it really doesn't do any harm because you're just trying to find something. So if it leads you down to a path that doesn't go anywhere, then fine, you at least tried it. And again, 50% of the time, it will help you locate a feature that you otherwise would have had difficulty finding in the first place. And then in addition to that, if you want to start searching for things just in your NetSuite system, you can always come up here to the setup tab itself. So if you click on this, and this is something a lot of consultants know, but I've noticed that many administrators just aren't aware that this is even here. The Setup Manager is a great place to quickly interact with various features without having to go into a bunch of drop-down menus and tabs. You can come in here and it kind of takes a look at everything related to setup and allows you to interact with it in one place. So for example, if I wanted to look for features related to invoicing, I can type in invoice, and it's gonna give me a list of invoice related features, preferences, et cetera, on the left here. And it's gonna show me where they're contained. So I can see I've got under accounting, invoicing preferences, I've got invoicing preferences, and I can easily click on this and it will load that specific page. So I don't even have to leave this setup manager and I can see, oh, great, this is what this thing is. Good to know. Down here we have, I can see under company, enable features and accounting, I have something related to invoice your customers. Maybe I wanna take a look at that. I can click on it. It will take me to that enables features page and I can scroll down and I can see the red line here is the exact feature. So then if I want more information, I could go to Suite Answers to get additional insight onto this particular feature. Or if it's not exactly what I'm looking for, I can keep going down and say, well, maybe it's invoicing groups. I click on that. It brings me to a separate enable features page. I simply scroll down, I go to the exact red line, you get the idea. So this is an excellent tool and one that most consultants use constantly to very rapidly locate the kind of features and preferences you're looking for and enable, change, et cetera, whatever those are. So that's a quick look at enabling features and preferences in the NetSuite system. And with that in mind, I hope to see you in the next video.